Thank you for that beautiful, warm reception. It's a great joy to be back in China again. And Francis was reminding me that this is our fifth time and over 5 years. We feel your hearts, and you are what draws us to come here. Because we share a deep calling to be happy. To live a life of happiness coming from inside of us. Not a false happiness is based on circumstances and outcomes of the world. We should be just as happy looking at a city or at the trees in nature. Just as happy if we live with people or whether we live on our own. Because happiness is something that comes from our source, from our Creator. And recently, I've just been experiencing very deeply that Jesus is behind everything that's going
on.
That he loves us so dearly, and he's arranging everything for our happiness and healing. So I've been laughing a lot and singing songs. Feeling like the birds, just singing all day long. Because I feel so much love in my heart. And whether you are new to A Course in Miracles or you've been studying it for years, it is my prayer that this weekend will be very helpful and very practical for you. And I want you to feel free to raise any theme or issue that you want.
我希望你能够感觉到你有这个空间去提出你心里面所有的问题。
And ask any question that you feel guided to ask.
你就是受到指引和召唤，想问什么都可以。
And please don't hold back, because your question is really everyone's question.
请你不要迟疑或者退缩，因为你的问题实际上是所有人的问题。
And when one of us wakes up from this dream, we all wake up together.
所以当其中一个弟兄能够从这个幻境中觉醒起来，所有的人也会跟着你一起觉醒。
So your part is essential for the whole universe.
所以你的这个角色是对这个全宇宙的决定是非常重要的。
This is no small thing that you're doing in your spiritual practice.
你现在所做的这些事情不是一件小事。
Every loving thought you share blesses the whole universe.
你的思想里面所想的每一个有爱的念头都会造福于全宇宙。
And when you seem to be afraid, then the whole universe is afraid.
如果你心里面有恐惧的念头的话，全宇宜宙都会有恐惧的念头。
So it is important to be free from fear as swiftly as possible.
所以我们的愿望就是你能够从这个恐惧当中越快地解脱出来越好。
There is no point in holding on to limiting beliefs and thoughts.
所以如果要是把自己陷在这个局限的思维和信念中，这个是没有什么必要的。
You hold the key inside your own heart.
真正解决问题的一切的钥匙都是在你的内心里。
Even if you've had a very difficult past, you always have had the key in your hand.
不管你过去的这个道路有多么艰难，这个钥匙还是掌握在你的手中。
And you can simply turn the key and walk out of the prison.
你完全可以在此时此刻就把这个钥匙打开这个枷锁，然后走出监狱。
Now the ego is a very tricky belief system.
那小我是一个非常狡诈的、诡计多端的这样的一个信念系统。
It is more slippery than a slippery fish.
它比那个就是在水里游的鱼还要狡猾，还要滑。
It finds all kinds of ways to hide.
它能够找到各种不同的方法去隐藏，把自己隐藏起来。
It tries to disguise itself and keep from being known.
它可以化身同不同的样子，然后去隐藏自己，这样让你找不到它。
And it's always under the surface lurking there.
它总是就在表面的这个层面之下，但是一直是存在于这里。
Until you take the cover off of it and don't protect it anymore.
一直到你能够把这个面纱完全的揭开，不再去保护它。
In the light, the ego disappears.
是在光明中小我才会化解。
It's like a little spider that when you take the lid off, it's just visible.
就像是比如说一直在暗中生活的蜘蛛，你一旦把这个瓶色盖取下来以后，它见了光以后，它就会不知所措。
And the ego has no power to scare you unless you give it the power.
如果你不赋予它这个力量的话，小我是没有任何力量能够使你感到恐惧的。
So we are all learning to pull our mind's power away from the ego.
所以我们现在要学的就是如何能够把力量从小我的里面拉到回自己的心灵当中。
The ego was made by belief, but it is dispelled as we withdraw belief from it.
小我之所以存在，是因为我们给了它一个力量，所以它能够存在这个信念系统当中。但是我们也可以把这个力量拿回来。
Now, the secret to making this very short path.
如果就是说，在把这个行程缩短，变成一个非常快的一个旅程的秘密，就是
，is to realize that you have no reason for any guilt ever.
就是能够意识到，你永远都不需要活在罪疚当中，没有任何事情能够使你感觉到罪疚。
There is not good guilt or bad guilt. There is no guilt.
没有好的罪疚感，或者是坏的罪疚感，没有任何事情应该值得你感觉到罪疚。
This is what the correction or the light in the mind will show you.
这个就是光明在你心灵中的光明，最终将会展现给你的。
That there has never been a reason for guilt.
它将展现给你是没有任何理由值得你感觉到内疚的。
Guilt is a product of linear time.
因为内疚是建立在线性时间的基础上的。
It is always remembered from the past or anticipated in the future.
它总是在你记回忆起来过去或者是期待未来的时候才会出现。
But right now, in this moment, there is no guilt.
但在此时此刻，如果你活在当下的话，你是不会感觉到罪疚的。
So we must.Find a way to live in this moment.
所以我们一定要找到一个方法，能够使我们只活在当下。
Completely trusting.
完全的信任。
That everything we need will be given to us.
我们所需要的一切都会赋予给我们。
Every person we are to meet.
我们需要见的每一个人。
Every need will be met.
每一个需求都会满足给我们。
We can have.A complete disinterest in the future.
我们可以对未来一点 希望也 不给予他了。
We have three more journeys to come.
现在三个新的同学。
So, our journey will be a journey together to see the reality of this fact.
所以这个旅程实际上是我们一起去进行的一个旅程，这个旅程就是要看到实相是怎么样。
We will see that we can let go of trying to control the world.
我们应该可以看到我们是需要放弃对这个世界的控制欲。
Of trying to control relationships.
放弃对关系人际关系的控制欲。
Of trying to control our body's survival.
或者试图去控制我们身体上的需要。
Of having to be in control of finances.
或者是对金钱对我们的财务状况的控制。
And free of controlling the environment.
甚至是要放弃对这个外界世间的这一切环境的控制。
The ego made this world of time and space.
因为小我是营造这个线性时间的宇宙和空间的幕后指使者。
And it wants us to try to control what it made.
然后他希望我们能够对他所营造的这一切加以控制。
Instead of having a still mind and being very content and happy.
与其享受当下的宁静这个状态，然后允许一切该发生的发生，它要求我们去控制。
It tries to draw us into the appearances.
它试图用这个方法使我们一而再再三地陷入这个表象的幻想当中去。
It tries to teach us some appearances are more important than other appearances.
它试图告诉我们有一些表象的现象是好的，或者是更重要的，有一些是不重要的。
But the Holy Spirit sees that they are all the same.
但在圣灵的眼中，所有的表象都是一样的。
We can just pass them by, all of them.
我们就可以在当中穿梭过去，不受影响。
And feel the peace that was ours in our creation.
然后感觉到内心的宁静，从我们造物主那得来的内心的宁静，可以一直伴随着我们。
So we start to live more like the plants.
所以我们可以在生活的状态下，越来越像是，就好像外面那些树啊和植物啊。
I see the trees out the window. They're very content.
外面我现在看到窗外那些树，它们就看上去就非常的满足。
They don't have the need to be busy, always moving and moving.
他们好像没有这样的一个欲望，就要一直非常的忙碌，要一直不停的动。
We can learn a lot from their majesty.
我们可以从他们的这种状态中学到很多东西。
And the trees do not give a thought to the weather.
他们也不会对这个天气状况有更多的想法。
Sunny day or a cloudy day.
如果是有太阳的和没有太阳，对他们没有影响。
They're just there, of beholding everything.
他们也就是在同样的一个状态下，一直观察着一切。
And we need to relax and be that content.
然后我们就是要做到心灵上的一直是放松的状态，去满足一切的事物的现象。
It is the ego that invented the doer.
小我实际上营造了这样的一个状态，是要一直不停的去做。
And the ego tells us we are human doings.
然后小我告诉我们，我们是要不停做事情的人类。
It would eliminate the idea of being.
然后他会认为我们不是一个处在一个平静状态下的一个状态。
Because it wants us to remain busy and distracted.
因为他想让我们一直在忙碌和被，就是被我们的思想所萦绕的这样的一个状态。
Never stopping to appreciate the being that we are.
这样的话，我们就可以一直不停下来，然后也没有机会去享受内心现在此刻的宁静状态。
Yes. So this is a great opportunity for us to realize this.
所以现在就是一个很宝贵的一个机会，我们能够一起回忆起这个状态。
and to come back to the simplicity of this moment. To begin to see that this is practical. And what we thought was practical before, striving and pursuing the future, has really never been practical. So I think we will have very good questions and answers. Because we want all the questions to be allowed to arise. Because the questions come along with concerns. And it is important that we have our mind washed of all concerns. Whether they are regrets from the past, or worries about things that may seem to come in the future, they are the distractions we must face. And I believe I will talk a lot too about my experiences of coming to this state of mind. Because the experiences of David are nothing like I imagined. I never saw anything coming. I didn't wish for certain types of circumstances in my life. I simply surrendered that over to the Spirit and said, "You know what's best." And I do not. So I will accept whatever you send to me. And so every day seems to bring something that is brand new to me. Come. We have a little one coming and joining us today. No problem. So, I think we have our microphone. And we have a nice small group here. So I think this weekend we can get into themes very, very deeply. And if you're following a theme and if you lose it sometime, then just take the time to say, "Oh, I have a question. I don't understand what that means." Okay, here we go. There we go with questions.
You 这一次来就想问大卫一个问题，就是我近两年很喜欢打坐，然后我就想
I came with this question. Last couple of years I enjoy meditation a lot.
冥想，然后这个对结合奇迹课程的修行来说怎么更好的结合？
How do I combine the practice of meditation with the practice of Course in Miracles?
我记得就是葛瑞是在打坐的时候阿顿白萨才来到的时候。
And I know that for Gary Renard, it was during his meditation that he met Arden in person.
作为中国的这个奇迹学员了以后，就是现在就是想请大卫回来。
So as someone who practices A Course in Miracles here in China, what advice can you give and how to combine these two practices? Because meditation is a very traditional practice here in our culture.
有一些在修炼奇迹课程或者是什么有一种启示，有点像神经病的样子。
在修炼奇迹，
就是修炼奇迹课程了以后就，就是不像人一样的，就不是正常人一样的。
So, I feel after practicing A Course in Miracles, there are many experiences where it's out of this world.
就是通过打坐可以来解导这个。
And it seems like meditating can bring us back to earth. So how to combine these two? Thank you.
Yes, in A Course in Miracles, Jesus has an amazing thing to say.
耶稣在奇迹课程里面有一个很重要的话。
He says that this course has everything that you need.
他说这奇迹课程这本书有你所需要的一切的东西。
When I first read that line, I thought, wow, that seems to be all inclusive.
但当我第一次读到这句话的时候，我想这个是不是有点太绝对了？
And it matched the feeling that I had that I could stop many things in my life.
但是它确实跟我心里面的直觉是相符合的，因为我觉得我其实可以停止其他的追求。
Because I was reading many different books and many different spiritualities.
因为在那个时候，我还是很广博的去读各种各样的书啊，还有去探讨各种各样的灵性的道路。
And I had meditation practices.
我也一直在打坐，当时。
But I had this feeling like I was starting from the beginning with Jesus.
但是当时我的感觉就是我要从头开始跟着耶稣一步一步走。
And it first came to me to use the book like an oracle.
所以在开始的时候，我实际上把奇迹课程这本书是当成就好像是算命的一样，就是随便翻。
To pray and have a question, then open the book.
然后我
自己
不会祈祷，然后静默，然后就直接打开随便一页，看看里面的答案是什么。
So for the beginning of my use, that was the way that I used the book.
所以我这个是我在开始奇迹课程的修炼的时候，我是如何在用这个书。
But I had the feeling that this book would lead me into a very deep.Meditation.
但当时我其实是有这个感觉，就是如果我一直跟着这本书修行下去的话，它可以把我带到很深的冥想状态中。
And I discovered that the workbook lessons were the design of that meditation.
它其实就是后来我发现，实际上就是365课的这个手册练习手册，实际上就是一个加深冥想程度的这样的一个练习。
That inside of certain lessons was actually meditation instruction.
所以实际上在这个每一个练习当中，实际上是对你冥想的一个指引。
So I approached these exercises with great humbleness and humility.
所以当时在我每次做这个练习的时候，我都是以非常大的谦卑的心去对待这些练习的。
saying to myself, Jesus is teaching me how to meditate.
然后我对自己说，耶稣现在正在教我该如何冥想。
In a way that sometimes my eyes are open and sometimes they're closed.
这种冥想有的时候是需要我的眼睛是闭上的，有的时候眼睛是睁开的。
Sometimes I practice when my body is very still, and sometimes when my body is in motion.
有的时候身体是静止的，有的时候身体是还在继续做不同的事情。
He was teaching me a way to meditate that was not really dependent on the body.
他其实是在教我进入这样的一个冥想状态，这个冥想状态是跟身体的状态是没有关系的。
Because any form of meditation that is focused on the body.
因为任何的一个冥想的一个练习，它如果是注重于身体的状态的话，
whether it's a behavior of the body, like sitting in a particular posture.
比如说，它是要求你的身体是在必须要保持一种什么状态，比如说是静坐的状态。
Or breathing in a particular way.
或者是以这种特定的状态去呼吸。
Or looking to be a certain way.
或者是看上去要一个什么特定的状态。
Comes with an expectation in the mind.
这个在你的心灵上面就会对此练习造成一种期待状态。
And even being concerned with time and the body.
甚至会在时间线上有对时间也有一个期待。
The time is to meditate.
是不是到了该静坐的时间了？
How long to meditate?
我需要打坐多长时间？
How many times to repeat meditation?
然后每天要练习多少次？
These again can all be taken over easily by the ego.
这些都是可以被小我加以利用的。
Because the ego wants to keep the mind addicted to time.
因为小我的目的就是想让我们的心里面完全对这个时间是上瘾的。
Addicted to rituals.
对这种仪式是上瘾的。
And so I realized that Jesus still would introduce some structure.
所以我当时实际上意识到，耶稣还是要会要求我做有一些一定的。具体的步骤。
And there is structure with the workbook.
就像我们的练习手册实际上是有固定的那个具体的建议的。
But it's a very light structure.
但是非常简单的一些建议。
And the more you proceed with the workbook, the more the structure starts to fall away.
然后你越是进一步加深的练习，这个表面上的这个结构就开始松散了。
It's like a child who's learning to ride a bicycle.
就像是一个小孩第一次学骑自行车一样。
Sometimes you have your parents' hand holding onto the seat.
有时候你需要你的父母在背后抓着这个自行车。
For me, I had that, and I had little wheels connected to the bike as well.
我当时不仅需要我父母在后面抓着，我还要需要买那种自行车是有其他的轮子支持主要的这两个轮子的。
My parents made sure that I did not fall off the bike.
然后我的父母当时是要保证我不会从这自行车上摔下来。
And that's how Jesus introduces the workbook.
这也是基督是如何想要我们开始练习这个练习手册。
He doesn't want us to fall off of the practice.
他不希望我们一下就从这个练习的这个惯性当中掉下来。
He doesn't want to push us too hard or too fast.
他也不想把我们推得过快。
He knows that we will have resistance to doing the workbook.
他知道我们对做这些练习会有抗拒心理。
Because if we do the workbook well, the ego is gone.
因为如果我们真的是很好的去做一些练习的话，小我就一定会被化解。
Gone forever.
永远的被化解。
And so is all fear.
同时也所有的恐惧都会被化解。
So the ego does not want you to do these training lessons.
所以小我是不希望你会一步一步的做这些练习手册的。
I meet people around the world who will study the text.
然后我在全世界遇到很多人，他们都会看着正文， 拽正门不放。
And read and reread the manual for teachers.
然后而且也对这个教师手册一直不停的去研读。
But they tell me I cannot bring myself to do the workbook lesson.
然后他们跟我说，但是我就是做不了这个练习手册。
They say I feel too controlled.
然后我原因就是我可能感觉到是被控制的。
Like someone is trying to control my day.
就好像有一个什么力量要求我要控制我的生活一样。
And then I meet people who love the workbook lessons.
但是我也遇到很多人，他们是非常热爱去这个练习手册。
And they say it's like my whole day is set up for the workbook lesson.
他们感觉到他们的每天的生活实际上就是为了这个练习手册而设定的。
They are amazed at how synchronized all the events are with the lesson.
他们感觉到非常神奇，就是他们每天遇到的一切事情都是跟这个练习手册的要求是吻合的。
Just a couple days ago, Francis was reading me an email.
就在两天前啊 ，Francis 给我读了一个他收到的电子邮件。
From a man named Peter.
是一个叫 Peter 的人给他发的。
Who said that whenever he does the workbook lessons.
然后他说他每一次在做练习手册的时候
，He gets like a fire in his eye.
他的就感觉到他的眼睛里面像是喷火一样。
And it feels like the devil goes into his eyes.
就像恶魔就活在他的心中。
And Francis said, David, did you ever hear such a thing?
然后我当时去 Francis 就问我，你听说过这样的情况吗？
He said, no, in 30 years, that's the first time I've heard that one.
然后我说我在我的过去的30年中，我是第一次听到这样的情况。
But he was asking very sincerely in email, what do I do?
但他是问在邮件里问一个非常诚心诚意的问题，就是我到底该怎么做。
And this is why we must have a lot of trust to do the workbook lessons.
所以就是举这个例子，就要说明我们要做这个练习手册是需要很大的诚心的。
Because those lessons are the practical application of the principles.
因为这个365课程实际上是对这个原则的一个具体的实施方式。
You want to develop habits with the workbook lessons.
你需要去建立这样的一个习惯，去根据这个课程去这个练习去建立这样的一个习惯。
That with practice become very good habits.
然后使得就是你养成这个每天练习的这样的一个非常好的一个习惯。
That will help you out of all emergencies.
这种习惯将会使你在遇到紧急情况的时候知道该怎么处理。
And everything you judge to be an extreme situation.
然后每一次你在遇到在你的那个小我的评判系统中认为是非常极端的情况的时候。
So traditional meditation was aimed at quieting the mind.
所以在传统意义上，冥想的目的就是要使这个心灵达到寂静状态。
And Jesus mentions this in his text.
然后，基督是在正文里面提到过冥想这一个练习方式。
He mentions meditation by name.
他明确地指出了冥想这一个练习方式。
And he says, this is a means that will succeed.
他确实说到冥想打坐的这个方式是可以使你成功的。
Because of the purpose of meditation.
原因就是他的这个目的。
But he says that this can be very tedious and time consuming.
但他同时也说这个可能会花很长的时间。
So he's like implying that meditation alone can take a long time to achieve the goal.
所以他实际上是在一语道破地指出，如果你只是用冥想的打坐试图去觉醒的话，将会花很长的时间。
And then he tells us your way will be different.
他同时下一句话就说出，但是你的道路会是不同的一条道路。
And that the means he is giving us is called holy relationship.
然后这个道路的方式他给我们的方式就是神圣关系。
And this is something that the ancient traditions did not talk too much about.
那这个方式在我们的古代或者是传统的这些修行里面是不怎么提到的。
They would say, find a good cave or find a good tree.
因为传统的方式都会要我们去找一个山洞或者在一棵树下。
Just find a place to sit.
就找到一个好的一个地方一坐就可以了。
And don't worry too much about all your relationships.
不要对你的这个人际关系上花太大的精力。
They are all thoughts that you are struggling with.
他们都是你心灵中的一些念头。
But even though we were told that the people were thoughts,
但是尽管说我们在我们被告知人实际上是我们的思想是念头。
Sometimes we were tempted to tell Buddha, tell that to my mother.
但有的时候我们心里会想，会哭点佛陀说，那不如你去告诉我妈妈这个真理吧，
叫我妈妈去。
So we do need a system of discipline.
所以我们确实是需要这样的一套系统，是有计划、有结构的这样的一套系统。
That takes us into an experience.
然后这套系统可以使我们逐步的踏入到这一个具体的体验当中。
That everything we perceive in the world.
这个体验就是我们所看到这个世界的一切表象。
Is all a thought
全都是来自于我们心灵当中的思想。
That there are no bigger thoughts and smaller thoughts.
并没有一个大的或者小的不同的念头。
In terms of the world.
对这个世界的表象来说。
And there are no more important thoughts or less important thoughts.
也没有更比较重要的或者比较次要的思想念头。
That all of the thoughts of this world are equally the same.
所以我们对这个世界所有的一切的思想念头都是一样的。
That there are not some that are easier to forgive and less easy to forgive.
也没有一些念头是比较容易被宽恕的，然后有一些是比较难被宽恕的。
At one point, Jesus says, "This is a world of ideas."
在书里面呢，有一点啊，基督耶稣就提到，整个这个世界就是一个思想的世界。
But when we start to divide the world of ideas.
但是当我们把这个思想这个世界一点一点区分开来。
And we say some of them are beautiful and some are ugly.
然后我把它区分成有一些比较美丽的，有一些比较丑陋的表象。
And some of them are loving and some of them are guilty.
然后有一些人是具有爱的，有一些人是是有罪疚的。
And some of them are of the body.
然后有一些是跟身体有关的。
And we endow all these thoughts with equal power. When we endow all these thoughts with equal power.
然后当我们对我们脑子中的这些所有的思想都给予他们同样的力量的时候。
This gives rise to a feeling of guilt.
这个时候我们就会在心里面就会产生罪疚感。
And we must learn that the thoughts that we think.
所以我们一定要学习去感觉到，就是我们认为我们自己思考的这些思想。
And the images that we think we see.
然后和我们外界所看到的这一切表象。
Do not come from who we are.
并不是从我们真正的源头来的。
And do not come from spirit.
也并不是从圣灵的角度来的。
They are make-believe thoughts.
他们都是小我所营造出来的。
But the guilt comes when we identify with them.
但是每当我们把自己认同于这个思考者或者这个营造者的时候，我们才会有罪疚的感觉。
This means we have taken our identity and given it over to the images.
这个就是在当时这个情况下，我们就是把我们自己的身份，然后把它认为是跟这些表象是一样的。
And even though the ego made this world.
哪怕是小我营造的这个世界。
It has taught us that the world made us.
但它却跟我们说，实际上是这个世界造就了我们。
This is a very human belief.
这个是我们人类非常通常的这样的一个信念。
Somebody asks you, where did you come from? And you tell them a location in time and space. And you talk about your mom and your dad. Or maybe you came from a test tube. You talk about the test tube. You have a story associated with this birth. And you seem to be originating in time and space. Instead of from God. Or spirit. Or love. But it really can't be both ways. We can't be both offspring of an eternal spirit. And a product of time and space. And this is what the Holy Spirit must convince us. That we have an eternal creation. And that all of these thoughts of this world are a trick. To keep us from knowing who we really are. And we have great parables throughout history. Parables of Siddhartha. Who's from time and space. And Buddha. Who comes from eternity. Or Jesus from time and space. And Christ from eternity. Who talks about the I am presence.
他就会跟你讲我是,
that is there before time or history.
就是说我的本质是来自于时间之前的。
So, when we meditate,
所以当我们在冥想的时候,
we are asked to drop deep into the mind.
我们实际上会要求自己去很深入地进入到我们的心灵状态中。
Beyond and beneath these distracting thoughts.
要一直深入到这些干扰的这些念头之下。
That are telling our mind that we are something we are not.
然后不会被这些干扰念头所打扰，这些干扰念头只是会告诉我们，我们不是我们本质本身。
And so, another aspect that we learn when we practice the workbook.
所以另外在我们练习这个练习手册还有另外一点。
Is the practice of following guidance.
另外一点就是要一直不停地练习去遵守圣灵的一个指引。
If it's too frightening to let go of all the thoughts of the world,
如果让你放弃对这个世界所产生的一切的念头想法实在是太难的话,
we need a bridge.
那么我们就需要一个桥梁,
a bridge to cross over.
这个桥梁会带着我们到另外一端去,
where we learn to follow the guidance within.
这个桥梁就是要我们去看到内心里面的这个指引,
in a very practical way.
然后是非常实际的一些指引。
Until it becomes so relaxed and so automatic.
我们要一直不停地去跟随这个指引，直到它变得是非常的，非常容易。
That we merge with the guidance.
到最终我们就会跟这个指引交融成一体。
And it becomes involuntary.
然后变成是不自主的。
We don't even have to ask, what should I do today? The guidance takes over the puppet. To bring a blessing to everyone in the world. To help you realize that everything is for the whole universe. That nothing is happening to you as a person. But everything is happening for your mind. Everything is happening to free your mind. Without exception. Nothing is out of place. You are never a victim of the world. Nothing outside of you can harm you or hurt you. And this takes a lot of convincing. Because the ego will tell you that you are crazy if you believe that. It will say, who are you to even think such a powerful thought?
他会跟你说, 你以为你自己是谁啊, 既然能够相信这样的一个观点。
But that is a real thought.
但实际上这个观点才是你最真实的想法。
So, to me, that was my experience with the Course in Miracles.
所以对于我来讲, 这个就是我在奇迹课程这方面的一点经历。
When I opened up the book to do my workbook lesson,
所以每当我打开这本书去做他的那些手册的时候,
I only opened to one lesson.
我只是做一个练习, 每天。
My lesson of the day.
就是我当天要求做的练习。
And I would think, maybe today is the day.
每天我都会想, 也许今天就是这个时刻。
That I experienced the fullness of this lesson.
然后今天这个就是这样的一天, 我一定要把这一刻所带给我的所有的经历都要经历到。
So that I may drop the book.
所以今天就是我就可以完成了这本书。
And have no more lessons.
然后也从此不需要再做任何的练习。
No more thought of the future.
也从来也不会再去考虑任何的未来。
And just a feeling of freedom and happiness. And that was the workbook lesson for me. My friends would say, did you read ahead? Do you see this lesson coming in the future? I say, no, I'm not interested in that lesson. I have my lesson of the day. I will not look ahead. I may not even have to go there. I'm hoping I won't have to go there. This one is sufficient for me. To give my full heart. So that is the pathway that I took. And when I started with the course, I stopped reading the newspaper. I stopped reading all other books. Because I had this feeling, this book is for me. It is here to help me. If I give myself over completely. Thank you.
Thank you. 这样就忘一下。
I want to hug you.
He said, welcome home, brother. I feel
it. I'm going to have it for a
point. Are you specified cute? What is cute? And this is my first question. And the second one is how to release from the beauty.
所以他的问题就是，第一个问题就是你能不能具体的给我们介绍一下罪疚到底是什么？然后第二个问题是如何化解罪疚
？Guilt is the feeling that something has gone wrong.
罪疚实际上就是这样的一个感觉，就是有一些事情，它出错了。
太没有听明白。
出错了，有一些事情是。
And so then the question becomes how to let go or release this feeling of wrongness.
然后当你开始有了这样的，有些事情发生，该发生的事情没有发生，或者不该发生的事情发生了，有了这种错误感以后，下一个问题就是如何去化解它。
It's almost like.The mind is holding on or gripping something that is not loving.
所以在当时的那个情况下，你的心灵实际上是紧紧抓住一个不是爱的一个念头。
And it must find a way to let go.
然后他必须要找到一个方法，能够让他自然的去放松它，放开它。
So the first idea I will talk about is responsibility.
所以首先我想谈一下你的这个责任感。
Because the ego associates responsibility and guilt.
因为小我总是把责任和罪疚是连在一起的。
Responsibility and duty and guilt.
你的职责和你的责任还有罪疚都是一个词。
Responsibility and loyalty and guilt.
然后你的责任还有忠心，还有罪疚也是连在一起的。
And guilt is also associated with linear time.
然后罪疚感实际上也是在建立在线性时间上的。
Because the ego invented linear time.
因为小我是建立营造出了这个线性时间的概念。
The ego tells you you are guilty in the past.
然后小我就是会告诉你，你过去是有罪疚的。
That there has been much wrongdoing in the past.
你在过去做错了很多的事情。
That the present moment is very tiny.
然后现在此时此刻是非常微小的一点。
And the guilt just rolls over the present and moves into the future.
然后你的罪疚感是从过去来的，然后一直。带到现在的这个时候，也会一直带到你的未来。
The ego uses linear time to keep the mind trapped in guilt.
然后小我实际上是用线性时间的这个概念，使你一直沉浸于这个罪疚感中。
And the Holy Spirit says, the ego is a mistake.
然后圣灵实际上他就是认为，小我实际上就是本身的一个错误。
And you will only feel guilty if you keep repeating the same mistake over and over again.
你如果是一直不停不断的重复你的这个小我这个错误的话，你才会感觉到罪疚。
So the ego tricked the mind into believing in guilt.
所以小我是使这个我们的心灵相信罪疚。
And then it maintains the guilt by the repetition of this same mistake over and over again.
然后他又一直在维持我们心里的罪疚感，然后这个维持的方法就是我们一直不停的在重复当初的那个错误。
We have a movie in the United States called Groundhog Day.
然后我们在美国有一部电影，那个电影的英文名字叫 Groundhog Day。
土拨鼠日。
土拨鼠日，中文叫。
Yes, where the weatherman gets stuck in time, keeps repeating the same day over and over again.
因为当时那个天气预报的那个人就是被陷在这个时间的循环里，每天都在重复着同一天的日子。
And the actor is Bill Murray.
然后 Bill Murray 是那个男主角。
Yeah. And so the whole point of that movie is he must escape from the same day and come into a new purpose.
然后他那个电影的实际上的主旨就是说，他这个男主角一定要摆脱每天的这个时间上的循环，然后真正的达到解脱，然后要建立一个新的目标。
And in A Course in Miracles, we're told that this new purpose is forgiveness.
然后在奇迹课程中，基督就教导我们说，这个新的目标就是宽恕。
That the whole point of all of our experiences is to grasp forgiveness.
所以我们每天日常或者是在这个世界中所经历的一切，最终都要回到宽恕这个目的上。
Because forgiveness shows us that there never was guilt in the first place.
因为在宽恕的这个过程中，你就会实际的体验到罪疚是不可能的。
Forgiveness returns the mind to perfect innocence.
然后也是通过宽恕，它能够使我们的心灵回归到这个纯洁无罪的最初的状态。
And shows the complete impossibility of the mistake.
然后它能够给我们的心灵一个实际的这样的一个体验，就是罪疚是从来没有发生过的。
But just like with meditation, we can only find forgiveness inside the mind.
但是就好像我们刚才所说的那个冥想，实际上宽恕一定是来自内在的，来自内心的。
We cannot find forgiveness in the body.
我们不可能在我们的身体上或行为上找到宽恕。
Or in any of the images of the world.
或者在我们外在的这个表象中找到宽恕。
Because the ego made this world that we would never find innocence.
因为想我营造这个世界的目的，就是要干扰我们，使我们永远看不到纯洁本质。
And when you experience forgiveness in the mind,
当你在心灵里面体验到了宽恕这个体验，
you see that you never did anything wrong.
你会实际上意识到你从来没有做过任何的错事。
And you never did anything right.
而且你也没做过任何对的事情。
That you were completely mistaken about the body.
而实际上就是你对这个身体的这个是一个完全错误的一个认知。
And all the actions of the body.
甚至是身体层面的这些行为也都是一个错误的认知。
And the perception of the body and the world.
然后你对身体还有对这个世界的表象都是一个错误的认知。
It was all a big trick.
这都是小我的诡计。
To keep you feeling that you had done something wrong.
它这个诡计就是一直使你陷在这个感觉中，就是你做错了些什么事情。
Now think about this in terms of all your relationships.
然后你可以从这个角度去看待你所有的人际关系。
Wouldn't you rather think and feel?That everybody was perfect.
难道你不愿意从这个角度去看到每一个人实际上都是纯洁无罪完美的吗？
That when somebody came to you and said, "Oh, I feel so bad at what I've done."
当有人找到你跟你说，我对我做的这个感觉实在是太不好了。
You could just smile, give them a big hug, and say, "No, it's not true."
你就可以微笑着给他们一个很大的拥抱，跟他们说，这个不是真的。
You are so loved, and I don't perceive anything that you think you've done wrong.
你是完全被爱的，我看不到你所做错的任何事情。
We have the power to give that gift to everyone. To all of our friends, to all of our family members. To the people in the grocery store, to the farmers. And it feels so good to give that gift. It must come from the Spirit. Because the human being could never conceive of such a gift. And that has been the greatest joy in my life. When people meet me or write to me and say that they've done something wrong, I just feel in my heart, no, that's not the truth. And it's a joy to let the Spirit pour through me and give that gift. To keep teaching everyone you are not guilty. You are innocent. I see you as innocent. I will treat you as innocent. And I will think of you as innocent. And this is how we escape from guilt. By giving away that which we want for ourselves. By letting the Holy Spirit convince us it is true. It's the greatest feeling. And that is our escape from this world. Thank you.
I want to continue on with these two questions. The first one is, if everything, based on everything that you have said, do we still need to confess? What is the purpose of confession? That's the first one. And the second one is regarding reincarnation and karma. How do you, is there any truth to that? How do you look at that?
Well, I would say that confess means to not hide or conceal.
在我看来, 忏悔实际上就是一个
So as long as we have a feeling that we are hiding something,
所以呢,就是说只要我们还有这种感觉,就是我们是试图在掩饰一些东西的话,
or that we are protecting something,
或者我们在保护一些东西,
then confession would be a step towards forgiveness. The only reason we keep secrets and hide anything is because we have already judged something as wrong. And we don't even want to look at that. We would rather forget it. But still believe in it.
但实际上还是对它有信, 有信念的。
And this is where confession is needed.
所以在这个时候，忏悔是还是很有必要的。
It is a way of saying to the Holy Spirit,
忏悔实际上就是在向圣灵表达。
This thing I have done,
我做了这件事情。
But this thing I would undo.
但是我愿意化解这件事情。
This thing I have kept hidden.
这件事情我一直在留在我的心里面把它隐藏起来。
But this thing I would set free.
现在我就是想把这个释放出来。
So even in the church, when you go to a priest to make a confession,
因为在教会里，哪怕你去一个牧师面前去忏悔，
it's really a symbol of saying, I would not hide this secret anymore.
这实际上都是一个，等于算是一个符号，然后是我们对圣灵说，我不想再对此加以隐藏了。
I would be open and honest about all of my thoughts.
我想非常透明的，非常公开的，把我所有的信念全都摆脱出，全都呈现出来。
And in traditional confession,
那在传统意义上的这个忏悔呢？
The priest would say, "Then you are blessed."
然后这个牧师会说，你是被赦免了。
At the end of any confession, there must be a blessing.
所以在你做完忏悔的每一次，它都会有一个祝福。
Because that is how forgiveness works.
但因为这个就是宽恕的那个工作的状态。
There is no darkness that the light cannot shine away.
因为没有任何的一个黑暗点是光明驱逐不了的。
And when we hide nothing from the light, then the light takes away the darkness.
只要我们不对光明去隐藏任何的黑暗的这些点，那么这些所有的黑暗都可以被光明驱除。
And in the Bible, it says, "Perfect love casts out fear."
然后在圣经里也提到，完全的爱可以把带走你的所有的恐惧。
So that is confession in action.
所以那个实际上讲的就是在忏悔，忏悔是如何运作的。
Now let us take a look at the belief in karma.
那么现在我们再看一下，就是对孽障还有轮回的这个概念。
Karma is a version of the eternal law.
所以这个孽障实际上是对我们这个永恒的宇宙定律的。一种表达。
That what you give is what you receive.
它实际上的意思就是说，你给出去什么就会得到什么。
So in nirvana or in heaven, you give love and receive love.
所以在涅槃或者是天国的话，那么你给出去的是爱，得到的也是爱。
But in time,
但在现行时间的里面，
it is the belief that what you extend.Has a consequence.
你所给出的这些东西，就是说在这个表达里面是会有后果的。
And if you give something in time other than love,
所以在现行时间里面，如果你给出去的不是爱的话，
you seem to receive a consequence in time other than love.
那么好像在现行时间里面，你也会承受这个后果，就是不是爱的这种后果。
And so.In time, there are causes and consequences.
所以在现行时间的这个里面，看上去是有因也有果。
And if you believe in time, you face that relationship, cause and consequence.
只要你还对现行时间是相信的，那么你就会在看上去就会体验到这个因果关系。
But the miracle collapses time.
但是奇迹会消除这个线性时间。
It brings the alpha and the omega, the beginning and the end, back together.
他们会把起点和终点带到一起。
And so both Jesus and John Lennon.
所以不管耶稣基督还是约翰列侬。
Are teaching instant karma.
他们都在教瞬间的这个孽障。
John Lennon had a song called Instant Karma.
因为约翰列侬有一首歌，他的歌名就叫《瞬间的孽障》。
Even the Beatles. We're teaching the escape from karma. Is in this moment. Give your mind fully to this moment and you are free from the laws of karma. Because in this moment you can fully give love and fully receive the love. And I think this weekend we will explore this in great detail. Why it is important to devote your mind to the present moment. In order to free the mind.
So
in China we have a saying, put down the sword and become the Buddha instantly. Yeah. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, to drop the sword in this instant.
对，是的，是就这样，就是在此时此刻立刻放下屠刀。And
thus you drop all attack and all defense.
放下所有的攻击，放下所有的防卫。And
you can live in freedom instead of fighting.
所以在此时此刻，你就可以活在自由中，当中，而不是活在这个纠结当中。就不会再活在那种什么担心这个报应啊，这样的一种。And
I will be free from the worry. Of any cause and effect.
Yes. Yes.
Sure. Yeah. Here, I have a question. Originally, I know a saying called "You create your own reality." You create your own reality. But I also know that this world itself is not eternal. Is this not seem to be contradictory?
I've learned saying that you create your own reality, but at the same time, this world is not constant. It's like, you know, so it seems like there is confusion or inconsistency between these two beliefs.
Yes, the belief that you create your own reality.
就说你自己创造了你的
Is really a New Age belief, but it is not consistent with A Course in Miracles. If we would reinterpret that idea, we would say that God is the creator of reality. And the most you can do is accept the reality that God created. In A Course in Miracles, there is a section called The Laws of Chaos.
因为在奇迹课程里面也有一章节，那个抬头就是说这个混乱的道理，混乱的法则。And
the first law of chaos.
第一个混乱的法则就是
is that the truth is different for everyone.
就是我们认为真理对每个人来讲是不一样的。In
reality, the truth is one.
但实际上真理只有一个。One
love, one spirit.
只有一个爱，一个圣灵。One
mind.
一个心灵。And
no exceptions.
这个是没有例外的。But
the ego has invented separation and multiplicity.
但小我营造了分裂，营造了各种不同的这个，各种不同的表象。
And the belief that you have the power to create your own identity and reality.
然后他也是, 说服我们，就是认为我们自己可以创造自己的身份，何况可以创造自己的这些体验。
And so this belief in creating reality.
所以这个信念认为我们可以自己营造自己的真相。
Can lead to many other beliefs.
也就是会导致很多其他的信念。
For example, you can manifest the world any way you want it to be.
比如说有一个分支就是你认为你可以把你的生活或者这个世界创造成你想要的任何的情况。
You can manifest abundance.
你可以营造出很丰盛的这样的一个状态。
And manifest specific situations.
然后一个特定的一个具体的情况。
And the only value in the idea.
然后这个信念的唯一的价值
is that you have a very powerful mind.
就是能够使你自己相信你自己有一个非常强大的心灵。
But at some point you have to decide how you're going to use that power.
但是到一定的程度你一定要开始想考虑自己要怎么运用这个强大的心灵。
Will you use that power to keep changing the images?
你要把你的心灵运用在去不停的去创造这些变幻多端的表象吗？
With the belief you can make a better world.
然后去希望能够创造一个更好的世界呢？
Or will you use that power to forgive the world?
还是你运用这个强大的心灵去宽恕这个世界？
And wake up to eternal love.
然后从这个幻象中觉醒出来，回归到一体状态中。
That will be the most important decision.
这个才是最重要的一个决定。
Will I try to make a better illusion?
我到底是要创造一个更好的一个幻象世界？
Or will I wake up from all illusions?
还是从所有的幻象中觉醒过来？
And know myself as God created me.
然后真正体验到我是上主创造的这个真理。
We were laughing a little bit earlier.
然后我们今天早上还一直在开玩笑，在。
When we were told that there is a teacher who has come this very weekend.
因为我们听到有一个也是从美国过来的灵性导师，在这个周末也来到北京。
To do a retreat on manifesting abundance.
他的工作坊就是要教人们怎么去创造丰盛的这个
And that 20,000 people had signed up for the abundance.
我们听到有20,000的学员报名参加他的课程。
And 30 people are interested in A Course in Miracles and forgiveness.
然后同一个周末的话，我们有30个人对奇迹课程所要讲的东西感兴趣。
So we are very grateful for your presence to come.
所以我对你的选择感觉到非常的高兴。
Yeah, because we know how valuable peace of mind truly is.
因为我们实际上是知道，就是说平安的心灵是多么的有价值，多么宝贵。
他讲的不一定是创造宇宙，他讲的是清理空间系统。我说李正老师讲的不一定是光是创造宇宙，他讲的是清理空间系统。
He was just saying that teacher doesn't just talk about abundance, he also talk about limiting the beliefs and the come back to the present moment.
Yes. And that is the value of the finding the power in the mind.
这个就是说我们要找到这个我们心灵的这个力量，然后了解到它是多么的强大，这个是它的价值。
You can always find value in a teaching that points to the power of the mind.
不管是什么样的法门或者是教导，只要它是能够让你意识到你的心灵的强大的，实际上都是有价值的。
And this is part of the Holy Spirit's convincing plan.
这个是圣灵的一个计划，这个计划就是要使我们不断的，最重要是说服我们。
If you are feeling very limited and very trapped,
如果你的体验是感觉到你自己是很受局限的，
and it seems like you are trapped by the world and circumstances,
好像是被这个世界所局限，或者是被一些具体的情形所局限的，
or even by thoughts and beliefs,
或者是被你自己的信念系统所局限的，
There is a call for help.
那么你的内心里面都是有一个需要想寻求帮助的这样一个召唤。
There is a cry for freedom.
你有一个非常强大的一个愿望，想要摆脱这些局限，获得自由。
And there is a feeling there must be more.
而且你心里一定有这种感觉，就是一定还有一些更多的东西是你不知道的。
More than my personality self.
在我的这个个体的这种体验中，这个一定不是全部。
Something that is vast.
肯定在这之外还有很多更广阔的东西。
So in my own journey, I had many such experiences.
所以在我的这个自己的道路上，我是有很多这样的体验。
Where things would appear in the world.
然后我会看到很多出现在这个世界中的情形。
That seemed to me to be very simple and easy.
然后在我看来是非常简单的。
That seemed to show up without my personal effort.
然后他这些情形就会出现，也不需要我去做任何努力，他就会出现了。
And I would find I had a big smile on my face.
然后每当看到他们的时候，我就会在脸上呈现出很大的一个笑容。
I would say that was nice.
然后我就会说这个还是很不错。
That was helpful.
这很有帮，对我很有帮助。
And I could see that these were symbols that were helpful to me.
因为这些就是一些迹象，它是对我很有帮助的一些符号。
Yeah. And it has been very good experience for me to come to China.
这些符号也是什么能够把我带到中国来的原因。
One time a woman came up to see me on the stage.
有一次我们在中国的时候，有一个朋友从台下到台上来跟我交流。
And it was on one of my visits to China.
这是我前几年一次来中国的经历。
And she said, I really have only one thing to say to you.
然后她说我只有一件事情要跟你说。
Give me money.
给我一些钱。
Give me lots of money.
给我很多钱。
I don't remember how many, it was millions, millions of yen.
当时要的那个具体的数字我忘了，但是好像是上百万。
I guess she thought that I was rich.
她可能觉得我很有钱。
But she did say, she said, please, this is just a request to help me release the belief in lack.
但是她当时确实是说了，说这个要求是希望能够帮助我到把我内心的匮乏感所化解掉。
And I said, well, I will pray about this.
然后我当时给他的答案就是我会对这个问题进行一下祈祷。
And then later when I saw her in the lobby.
然后当天晚一点时间，我后来在那个大厅里面见到她。
I did give her money.
我给她一点钱。
But I don't think it was the millions of yen that she expected.
没有她想象的那么多，没有上百万。
I said,This is what I'm guided to give you.
然后我说这个是我受指引要给你的。
And what I'm able to give you.
而且是我能力范围内能给你的。
So it's all about letting the spirit use the symbols.
所以最终还是要让圣灵去运用所有的这些符号。
To help us feel how loved we are.
最终就是要给我们一个心灵这样的体验，就能体验到我们是多么的被爱着。
And it's always about the love.
最终都是一切都是还是爱的体验。
Yeah.
嗯。
那我们说到
这儿，就是只有一个麦谁拿麦谁来听。我来说呗，这个没什么。哦，大点声吧。其实老师的这个讲解其实很多问题了，但我说重点吧。如果老师允许的话，我后面慢慢提啊。
I have many questions. I probably should focus on the most important one. But if you allow me, I will have more to come.
Okay.
就是，刚才老师提到过说，这个就是你比方说，每当一个人有愧疚感的时候，我们会对他说你是完美的，你是被爱的。我想就是，如果针对一个强奸的一个犯罪的人，那我觉得是一个心灵和行为的分开。是不是可以这样理解，就是他的那个强奸或者是一个抢劫，其实他也是在追求一个心灵的 或者无条件的爱。所以如果这样分开的话，那在心灵方面它是纯洁的，因为它是圣灵的这个降临嘛。然后在行为，它恰恰是一个局限性的或者错误性的信念指导它的一个行为。
Okay, I just whatever you just mentioned about seeing people as innocent, that is the way to heal the feeling of guilt. I want to ask, for some people, like a rapist, for example, does that mean that I have to see the mind and the behavior separately? Because the mind, he did it out of the call for love. So in that way, I can perceive him and his mind as perfect. But in terms of the action, it's actually driven by fear or by a limited belief. So is that what you were trying to say, that I have to separate the mind and the behavior?
Okay, this is a very good question because it points to a teaching from A Course in Miracles. In A Course in Miracles, Jesus tells us to overlook the body and the mind of our brother. So this is asking us to look beyond the appearance of the body.
So 要看看透它的表象。
And look beyond the mind that seems to believe in attack.
甚至要看透，要看穿他在做这些行为后面所指使的这些小我的信念系统。
Because when the mind is asleep and dreaming of separation,
因为当心灵是处于沉睡状态，并且认为分裂发生了的时候。
It believes that people each have a mind of their own.
他同时也相信每一个人有一个独立的心灵。
So if there are 7 billion bodies in the world,
因为所以这样的话，如果我们世界上有70亿人的话，
then there's a belief that there's 7 billion minds.
那小我的信念就是我们有70亿个独立的心灵。
A private little separate mind associated with each body.
每一个独立的，然后心灵都是跟每一个身体所对应的。
And that's just for the people. If we start counting the cows and the chickens,
这只是说的是人类。如果要是我们再加上那个狐狸啊，或者鱼啊，或者是牛羊啊，
so many separate minds.
那就更多的这种独立的心灵存在。
Trillions, trillions and trillions of separate minds.
有几百亿不同的独立的心灵。
And each separate mind still seems to believe in attack.
然后每一个独立的心灵好像都会去相信这种攻击念头。
I mean, if you see an angry cow,
所以你看到一个很生气的愤怒的公牛，
or an angry horse,
或者是一个愤怒的一匹马，
you see the actions of the horse,
你看到的只是这个马的行为，
but you're thinking, that horse is not happy, he's got angry thoughts.
但是你肯定会有这样的一个结论，就是这匹马并不开心，它是一个很生气的马。
Of course, the miracle is teaching us there's only one mind.
但是奇迹课程对我们的教导，我们只有一个心灵。
And when you have that mind believing in attack,
然后你的这唯一的这个心灵，如果你让它相信，攻击性是真的话，
it makes up a crazy world of images.
它就会在这个世界上投射出很多疯狂的行为。
Where you seem to see attack in many places.
那么你就会看到在外界体现出来各种各样的攻击。
All you have to do is turn on the news.
你所需要做的其实只是把电视打开，看看新闻就可以了。
Or look at the internet.
或者看看上网。
And you seem to see attack all over the place.
你可以看到攻击念头体现在全世界各个角落。
Jesus has a very simple answer for all of this misperception.
基督对这个在表象上的这个错误，实际上有一个很明确、很简单的答案。
And you can find it in workbook lesson number
23.
I can escape from the world I see by giving up the
tactile.
Now that makes a lot of sense. Because why would God create attack? If God is pure love, and only has loving thoughts,
也只会有爱的思想,
attack could not come from God. It must be another ego trick. Because remember, we're trying to escape from guilt. And guilt and attack and fear are all from the same error.
然后罪疚和攻击还有恐惧都是来自于同一个源头。
And this is how Jesus seemed to heal the sick.
这个就是为什么基督耶稣能够去治疗那些有病的人。
And how he would raise the dead.
他能够使死人复生。
It's because he saw that attack wasn't real.
因为他能够看到攻击念头不是真的。
He gave that ego belief back to God and said, take this away from me. So, it's not that we have to think of the body and the mind as separate. But we must be willing to overlook both of them.
但实际上我们必须要愿意去看透、看穿他们两者。
If we are going to see the light of innocence,
如果我们想要看到最后在这个表象后面的纯洁的这个光芒的话。
Three different times in this lifetime, I have had a revelation.
在这个我的一生有三次有一种启示的经历。
Where the whole world disappeared.
这个三维的世界完全的消失了。
And all was light. Just a sense of pure love and oneness. So those experiences help me see, oh, this is what the whole Course in Miracles is really about. Thank you for that question.
谢谢你问这个问题。
Okay. 还有一个顺带的问题，可以吗？
There's another question.
哦，对，那其实实际奇迹课程我没读过啊，当然我在这个信仰的过程当中，其实我接引了很多的这个高等能量的指引。我想说的一个就是，我觉得会不会是这样，就是在那个上帝把亚当和夏娃因为贪婪赶出伊甸园的时候之前，就是奇迹课程想让我们
I haven't really read A Course in Miracles, but I have a lot of guidance from the higher selves. So I guess I just want to follow up with what you're trying to say, and it's that A Course in Miracles is trying to bring us back to the state where it's before Adam and Eve were driven out of the Garden of Eden.
Yes, I would say that's exactly it. It's coming back to the state prior to the Garden of Eden.
确实是这样的，因为我们现在要回到的状态是处于亚当夏娃被驱逐出去那个班，在那个之前。
But Jesus talks about the Garden of Eden.
耶稣其实也谈到了那个伊甸园。
And he mentions the tree that was supposed to be in that garden. It's known in the Bible as the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
And
And in the Bible it says, God said, you can give all the fruit, but not from this tree.
在圣经里面，上帝就对这个亚当和夏娃说，你可以在这个伊甸园里面吃，或者是动所有的东西，但是唯独不要吃这棵树上的果实。
So in the Bible, this was the forbidden tree.
所以圣经里面把这棵树叫做禁树。
But in the Course in Miracles, Jesus said, God would never put you in such a situation.
但在奇迹课程里面，基督就说，上帝绝对不会把你放在这样的环境里面。
Think about a family in this world.
你想想在这个世界中的假如说一个家庭。
If the parents tell the child, never eat this chocolate.
如果是父母对他的孩子说，你绝对永远不要吃这块巧克力。
You can have any food you want in the kitchen, but just don't eat this chocolate bar.
你可以吃我们厨房里面所有的食品，但千万不要吃这块巧克力。
What is the child going to do?
你觉得这个小孩会做什么呢？
不知道。
You'll eat the chocolate bar.
你一定会吃这块巧克力。
And God would never put a tree of duality.
上主绝对不会把一棵二元性的树
in a garden of paradise.
放在天国的这样的一个伊甸园里面
and tell Adam and Eve, don't eat the fruit on this one tree.
然后跟亚当夏娃说，千万不要吃这棵树上的东西。
So, this is just a symbolic story from the Bible.
这个只是圣经里面讲的一个符号性的或者是一个比喻。
That if we would choose to believe in duality,
如果我们要选择相信二元性的信念的话，
that would be an evil tree.
那么就好像是我们吃了禁树上的果实。
Because reality is perfect love and oneness.
因为实相是一体性的，是完全是纯洁的。
And every day we have a chance to practice.
所以每天我们都有很多的机会去实践。
Living from love.
实践就是说在我们的每一时刻都是从爱的体验中去活出来。
Living from an experience of oneness.
然后从一体性的这个境界中去生活。
And not being tricked into believing there is another choice.
不要相信小我的这个轨迹，认为是有二元性的选择的。
There is a beautiful line from Jesus that I love.
在这本书里面有基督有一句非常美的话，我非常喜欢。
He says, "Truth will be returned to your awareness."
他说，真理会回到你的意识状态中。
By your desire.
是通过你的欲望和你的信念。
As it was lost by your desire for something else.
因为真理是在你的是之所以消失在你的心灵中，就是因为你选择或者是想要其他的一些东西。
And really, that's just the first commandment.
所以这个实际上就是十诫中的第一诫。
From the Bible.
在那个圣经里面也提到过。
Love the Lord thy God.
他要求你只爱上主。
With all thy heart and soul and mind.
用你所有的心 和你的思想 全心全意的爱上主。
And when you want only love,
如果你只要的只是爱的话，
you will see nothing else.
你不会看到任何其他东西。
Yeah. It's very straightforward, very simple.
所以这个是非常简单非常直明了的。
Yeah.
老师这样一说似乎这个把那个圣经的这个故事给否定了。同时我当时我有一个这个想法是，是不是上主是用奇迹？如果奇迹是这样的话，奇迹是这样的逻辑，就是你只连接这个，你不要去看其他的，那是不是对人类一次再次拯救啊
？So it seems like you have denied the story in the Bible, and if this is true, what of course the miracle is saying is true.Does that mean that is another chance to save the human race?
Yes, there are very interesting things in the Bible.
是的，在圣经中实际上是有一些很有趣的事情说法。
And For example, in the Bible, it said that Adam fell asleep.
比如说，像在圣经中，它提到亚当是沉睡过去。
But nowhere else in the Bible does it say that Adam woke up.
但是他在圣经里面，圣的篇幅里面，没有任何一个地方提到亚当醒过来。
So I think Jesus is offering us many chances.
所以基督实际上也给我们提供很多的机会。
To wake up from the dream of separation.
要求我们从这个分裂的这个梦境中醒过来。
And really, it's a very simple pathway.
实际上这个是一个非常简单的一个道路。
But he knows that when the mind is asleep and dreaming.
因为在我们的当心灵在沉睡和在梦境中的时候。
It is caught up in a lot of complexity.
只有在这个时候，他才会相信很多复杂的东西。
So he keeps offering us an escape hatch.
所以在这个过程中，实际上耶稣是一直不停的在给我们提供一些很简单的逃脱这个梦境的方法。
He'll say, "Here, try this."
他会说，试试这个方法。
Or try this.
或者试试这个方法。
Every day he says, "Try this."
每天他实际上都在跟我们交流说，试一下这个。
He keeps offering us opportunities to forgive and be happy.
他不停地给我们提供机会，让我们来宽恕。
And I was raised as a Christian and studied the Bible.
我从小长到大也是基督徒，然后也是学习圣经的。
And in the story of Genesis,
然后在创世纪的这个一篇里面。
It says God created the heavens and the earth.
它其实讲到上主是创造了天国，同时也创造了这个世界。
But in the course of miracles, Jesus tells us.
但在奇迹课程里面，其实基督耶稣是说
that God did create heaven.
上主是创造了天国。
But the ego projected the earth.
但是小我投射出了这个世界。
And that's why we need to forgive.
所以这就是为什么我们要宽恕这个世界。
We don't have to forgive God. God never did anything wrong.
我们不需要去宽恕上主，因为上主从来没有做过任何错事。
We have to forgive the ego.
但是我们需要宽恕小我。
And our belief in the ego.
还有我们对小我的信念。
So we can remember God.
只有这样的话，我们才能忆起上主。
Yeah.
三。
So how are we doing? Oh.
后面
十五分钟。
In the back.
谢谢大家。喂，三位老师好。
Thank you, David.
我来的前一天就开始兴奋起来了，有一首歌一直在我耳边飘扬过来，来看你。
I have this song that has been singing in my mind the last couple of days. I come over from across the ocean.
我就觉得是圣灵安排你来。来让我们相遇的，非常的感恩。
I really feel that you came here as a calling or as a guidance of the Holy Spirit, and I'm very, very grateful.
我接触奇迹大概有一年多的时间。
I studied the course for about a year.
对，一开始是非常非常抗拒的。
Had no resistance at the beginning.
我是一个非常有攻击性的人。
I feel like I have a lot of attack thoughts.
但是现在我已经开始臣服，我很相信奇迹。
But right now, I'm in a state of surrender. I really believe what the Course in Miracles is teaching.
对，我已经开始好好的做练习，读课文。
And I have been practicing the workbook lesson and reading the text.
但是还有很多疑惑。
But I still have a lot of questions.
我每天也和圣灵对话。
I also talk with the Holy Spirit every day.
对，我能接受到很多灵感。
And I can receive a lot of inspiration.
但是还是有一种信念，老师告诉我，真的有那个天国吗？真的有圣灵吗？我们真的可以不死吗？
But there's still a lot of doubt thoughts in my mind asking, is that true that there is a heaven? And is that true that there is a Holy Spirit? Is that true that we are eternal?
对，我经常我现在感觉到我不是害怕那些痛苦，而是我真的害怕我拥有爱。我经常就是面对喜悦和爱的时候会有恐惧，我就会问自己，我们真的可以无罪疚的享受这些吗？
I feel like I'm not in fear of the suffering of this world, but
I'm really in fear of the love. And every time I'm closer to the experience of love, I have this doubt that can I really accept that? Do I really deserve that without any sense of guilt?
So I want to
I just want to hear from
you.
Is that really true? I want to be able to continue on with confidence. Please give me some confidence that this is true. Thank you.
Well, even though you may have just read the course for 1 year, you are very close to the deepest meaning of the course. Which is opening up to this idea of being afraid of love. That seems to contradict so many of our experiences. But when the mind is asleep and identified with the ego, love becomes the greatest threat. If this whole world was made by a death wish, and love proves that there is no death. There could be nothing more frightening to the ego than love. Because love would prove that there is no ego. And if there is no ego, then there are no problems. And then happiness must be very easy. So the ego will say that this course is turning the whole world around.
The ego
would say that the course is trying to turn the world around. And that's exactly what we need to happen. To see that this world is backwards and upside down. That we cannot find any love in this world the way it is upside down. So the more that you listen to the Holy Spirit, the Spirit will try to convince you that you need to forgive. That you need to forgive the world. When I first picked up A Course in Miracles, my heart was very closed. And David was very shy. And very guarded. And very afraid of love. Afraid to even acknowledge love. But the more that I practice A Course in Miracles, I started to have heart-opening experiences. Even with people that I thought were strangers, I started to feel a connection. And I started to relax and let the Spirit work through me. And I started to see more reflections and witnesses of this love.
I
I started to find people that were happy people.
然后我会经常的跟一些很快乐的人见面。
And as I became happier and happier, then more people wanted to come and be around me.
然后当我开始变得越来越快活的时候，就开始有越来越多人想要围在我身边跟我一起生活。
And then I started to think, love is not so bad.
然后我就开始想了，这个爱的体验还不错。
I like this feeling.
我喜欢这种感觉。
And the ego said, you better stop this Course in Miracles right now. But over the years, I became more convinced that I could feel the love, and I had love inside of me. The only belief that we must overcome is the belief that we are unworthy of love.
所以唯一我们要克服的就是认为自己不配拥有爱这个信念。
And we have to be convinced by the Holy Spirit.
我们一定要允许圣灵去说服我们。
So that is why we have A Course in Miracles.
这就是为什么我们需要奇迹课程这个工具。
We let them come through us. We let them be given away.
我们需要让奇迹发生在我们的经历中，而且要不断推恩奇迹。
And then, as we do this, our awareness of love goes stronger and stronger.
我们越这样做，我们在我们的意识状态中，奇迹就会占据一个更强有力的一个位置。
And we can actually accept that we are love.
在这种情况下，我们就越来越能接受我们实际上就是爱这样的一个真理。
And it washes away the whole world that we saw before.
这样我们在过去的所看到的世界这些表象就会被冲洗干净。
We see the world in a brand new way.
我们就会以一种全新的一个视角去看这个世界。
It's just reflections of our loving thoughts.
然后这个世界就会完全的反射出我们在爱中的这个状态。
So it's been a very dear journey for me.
所以对我来讲实际上是非常宝贵的这样的一个经历。
And I can assure you and guarantee
我可以向你保证
that you are loved, very loved.
然后你是非常被爱的。
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, we have time for one more question before our lunch break.
今天上午最后一个问题，好吗？上午结束之前最后一个问题。
我们时间差不多了，下午也是。
然后问
我已经不知道我这个问题能不能再问得出来，我先讲下去。恭
喜你，
恭喜你。我。因为每当我要讲话的时候，在我内心当中会有一个声音在说，我又要开始编故事。
So every time I'm about to say something, there's a voice inside my mind saying, don't start making up stories.
我在我七岁的时候，我是一个非常倔强的小男孩。
When I was about 7 years old, I was very rebellious.
身边的小伙伴学习自行车，经过就是父母的帮助，他们大概需要3天时间。
Oh, my friends around me, for example, when they learn how to ride a bicycle, with the help of their parents, it took them about 3 days to learn that.
但是我自己坚信我自己会学会自行车，不需要任何人帮助。我大概用了10天的时间。
But I just had this firm belief that I could do it without any help.It took me 10 days.
在我不会骑自行车之前，我觉得这件事情非常难，这是一个问题。
Before I could ride a bicycle, I thought it was the hardest thing. It's a problem.
当我摔了很多跟头之后，我发现不会骑自行车是假的。我本来应该骑自行车。
But after I fell many times, I started to realize that.It is a false belief that I couldn't ride bicycle. I should be able to ride bicycle from the beginning.
所以 在生活中我会有很多的问题出现，然后这些问题都被解决了，但是还会有新的问题出现。
So in my daily life there are many many problems and as they are solved gradually there are more to come.
所以后来我发现问题是解决不完的，真相应该是没有问题才是真的。
So I realized that there is no end to the problems of the life, and truth must be a state of a state that there is no problem.
遇见奇迹课程有九年的时间了。
I have been with A Course Miracle for about 9 years.
但是每一天我都感觉这是一本我。每一天都会有一个声音说离那本书远一点，但是这个声音会越来越微弱。我每一天都在读。
Every day I've been reading the course, even though there has been a voice saying to stay away from the book on a daily basis, but this voice started to become weaker and weaker.
如果说现在有一个问题要问的话，就是我不知道什么是奇迹。
I guess my question right now is I still don't know what a miracle is.
我有过几次神奇的经验。
I have a few mystical experiences.
我有一段时间会保持一种非常喜悦的状态。
There are certain periods of time that I canStay in a state of peace and joy.
在夜晚睡眠没有梦境，然后持续一段时间。
And I can sleep during sleep. There's no dream.
因为这些故事，我渐渐的相信，我真的可能不是一具身体。
And all these experiences made me start to be open to this belief that I may not be a body, just a body.
但是这一切都没有意义。
But it seems very meaningless.
每一天在像，比如昨天晚上我依然会做梦，但是在梦境里面我也会在读书、读七课程，也会做练习。
So for example, yesterday last night I had a dream, and in my dream I was studying A Course in Miracles and doing the workbook lesson.
此时此刻我在想的问题是，在梦里面我是把梦境当真的。我不知道自己是谁。
So in my dream, I thought my dream was real.
所以这个宽恕功课在正文里课程里面讲是，我以为弟兄所做的任何事情都没有做过，这个才是宽恕。
So the definition of forgiveness in the text is that what I believe my brother did has never happened.
所以我现在我也不知道。我有什么问题要问，就是还是刚才那个问题，我想让大卫老师就是此时此刻讲一下什么是奇迹。
So I don't really even know what my question is now, but I just thought if you can talk a little bit about miracle and what it is, that would be good.
Yes, there are two words that come to mind.
有两个词现在进入我的脑子里面。
And one word is related to the spirit.
然后有一个是跟灵性有关的。
And one word is related to the ego.
然后有一个是跟小我有关的。
The ego word is get.
小我的这个词就是获取。
The ego wants to get.
小我一直想让你不停地去获取。
To own, to possess.
去积累，去拥有。
To control.
去控制。
And the word for the spirit is to give.
然后圣灵的这个词汇就是要去给予。
Even when we say forgive, it's forgiving.
然后在英文里面说这个宽恕，实际上的英文是 forgive， 实际上你把它分开来的话，就想到是为了给予。
And.Here's the reason I love China so much.
这就是为什么我这么喜欢中国。
I came here one time in 2012.
我在2012年的时候来过一次。
To do a tour of Shanghai, Hainan, and Beijing.
然后在2012年的时候，我是做了一个巡回的这样的一个，去先去上海，然后去海南，最后来北京。
So I land in Shanghai.
所以我是第一站是在上海。
It's a big room.
然后在上海的时候，当时我们是一个很大的一个会场。
And there's 225 people there.
大概225个学员在里面。
So I had so much fun.
然后我当时是非常的享受这个过程。
Then I flew down to Hainan.
然后我又飞到海南。
And a small group of people flew down with me.
然后有一个比较稍微小一点的一个这样的一个团队跟我一起飞过去。
So I said my opening talk.
所以在海南的时候，我就先做了一些开场的这样的一个演说。
And I said, does anybody have any questions?
然后我就说还有没有人有什么问题。
And the first man that raised his hand.
然后有第一个提问的同学在海南。
He said, I was with you down in Shanghai.
他说在过去几天我是在上海跟你一起。
And I listened to all of your talks.
然后我听了你所讲的所有的东西。
But I didn't get anything from any of your talks.
但我从那里面得到了什么都没得到。
I didn't get a single thing from your talks.
没得到任何东西。
So he said, now I'm here. I flew all the way to Hainan.
然后现在我从上海又飞到海南来了。
And I want you to tell me,
你能不能告诉我,
am I going to get anything at all from your talks?
在这几天能够从你这得到什么东西?
And I said, I love China. This is the best experience for me.
然后我说我真的是非常爱中国，这个对我来讲是非常有趣的一个经历。
I said, no, you won't get anything from me here either.
我说你从这儿也得不到任何的东西。
In fact, if you keep flying around and listen to me,
实际上如果你一直不停的飞来飞去，一直跟我在一起的话，
you will seem to lose everything.
你会看上去失去所有的一切的东西。
That you believe about this world.
你对这个世界所相信的一切东西都会被失去。
And everybody laughed. Everybody had a big laugh.
当时会场里面就爆发出一阵笑声。
Because the problem is getting.
因为真正的问题就出在要获取这个动机上。
Whether we read a book or we listen to somebody talk, we want to get something.
因为哪怕是我们去读一本书或者听一个人讲课，目的就是要得到一些东西。
And it's just a bad habit.
这只不过是一个坏的习惯而已。
Because the Spirit wants us to get into giving.
因为圣灵希望我们开始学会要给予。
To show up always to give.
不管我们去哪儿，我们出现的目的就是要给予。
To say what gift can I give today?
然后一直不停地问我今天能给出什么礼物出去。
And we get so happy when we become givers.
因为一旦我们接受了我们是一个给予者的话，我们会变得非常的快乐。
With everything that we do in our life, we become a giver.
在如果我们生活中所做的每一件事，最终的目的都是要给予。
So.I seem to, in this world, get an education.
所以在我的这个一生中，在这个世界中，我好像是得到了一些，比如说在大学里面获得了学位。
I seem to get a job, get a career.
我也得到了一份工作，有一个事业。
And get possessions.
也有一些存款。
And get learning and knowledge.
然后也获取了一些知识。
And get university degrees.
技巧还有大学的学位。
But at some point, Jesus told me, "Would you just stop?"
然后在但是在到了一定程度，其实耶稣跟我说，你还是放弃吧。
You're moving in the wrong direction.
你一直在向错的方向在走。
You've got to let it all go.
你需要把这一切都交托出去。
Everything that you've ever learned, you have to unlearn.
你在这个世界中所学到的一切知识，你最终还是要化解掉。
And you just spent 10 years in university.
然后你在大学和研究生里面花了十年的时间。
So I feel so happy now that I've emptied my mind.
所以现在我之所以这么快乐，因为我把我的心灵头脑都清空了。
And let go of all these thoughts and beliefs.
然后把我所有的信念和思想也都交托出去。
And let go of all these opinions.
也把我所有的这些观念也都化解掉了。
When people ask me if I have any opinions about politics,
有的时候人们会问我对这个世界的政治上面有什么观念
economics,
对经济上有什么观念
the environment,
或者对这个环境 有什么观念？
I say no, I don't.
我就说我没有任何的观点。
I have no opinions.
我没有观点。
They ask me, what do you think of Trump?
他们说你对特朗普有什么感觉？
Don't you have any opinions on Trump?
难道你对特朗普没有任何的意见吗？
No, I have no opinions.
没有任何意见，没有想法。
They say that sounds kind of boring.
那你看着你的生活非常无聊。
But no, it's not boring at all.
但是我可以跟你说一点也不无聊。
So it's good.That you are just open to emptying the mind.
所以我觉得非常好的是你现在开始敞开，想要化解你的这一切的信念。
And if you just move in that direction, you will become so happy.
如果你就一直向着这个方向走的话，最终你一定会达到非常喜悦的状态。
And the Spirit will provide you everything that you seem to need.
然后这个是圣灵的工作，就是圣灵会给我们提供我们所需要的一切东西。
In this world, learning seems to be so important.
在这个世界中，就是说要学习或者积累知识，好像是非常重要的一件事情。
But for the last 30 years, all I've been talking about is unlearning.
但在过去三十年里，我一直教的就是要让大家去化解他所学到的东西。
Buddha had it right. Empty the mind of everything.
因为佛陀也曾经说过这样，就是你要把你的思想理念全部都清空。
That's why we have the laughing Buddha.
这就是为什么我们会有这种笑，一直在大开怀大笑的佛陀的形象。
Yeah, empty mind is full of laughter.
清空你的思想以后，你就会一直在处在这个喜悦的状态中。
So let's go have some lunch.
所以现在我们可以去吃一些午餐。